I want to talk a little bit about what you were saying towards the end. So it feels like there was a lot of damage done in, well, terms of everything in these last 4 years, and education is no exception. And so I'm wondering, as you think about the future of the K-12 education space, of the charter space, what are you hoping to see from this new administration?
I'm hoping to see a couple of things. I'm hoping, first of all, to see educators not just at the table, but in leadership. I think that, you know, I used to work on Capitol Hill with my friend David Johns, who I think is also on here. Shout out to him, because he knows what it is to be on the inside the Beltway in Capitol Hill, on the Senate side, in the White House. And to work so hard to bring the voices that matter most into not just the room, but into positions of decision making. And that's what I mean by saying more than just at the table. We like to use that phrase, I want to give you a seat at the table. Well, when I get that seat at the table, am I being served the same meal as everyone else? Am I being given the same room to speak as everyone else? Am I being sat at the head of the table or at the end of the table? And who built this table anyway? Whose table is it that you want me to take a seat at? These are all of the questions that we need to be asking ourselves when we are building better futures for and with our young people, right? If we are doing it for them and not with them, if we are doing it to them and not with them, then we are engaging in the same kind of white supremacy practices that we say we're trying to eradicate. So we have an opportunity, I think, in this administration to make sure that educators and young and students are not just in the room, but that they actually have decision-making power, that we are co-designing what the future of education looks like with the actual users, with the actual end users of this work, with the actual young people and educators who will be delivering the content and the young people who will be receiving and engaging in it. So that's the first thing. The second thing I would say is, and this is my desire across all of the policy areas, is that a racial justice lens is applied to all decision-making. I did a lot of TV hits the other day when, you know, kind of as the Biden-Harris administration has really hit the ground running with these executive orders, there have kind of been two kinds of executive orders to come out of this White House. There have been corrective executive orders. So they've looked at the list of things that were totally broken in the last administration and said, we need to fix these things quickly. And then there have been executive orders toward progress, right? Things that we actually need to build toward and build upon. And in that second one, we saw a number of racial justice executive orders come out. And so y'all know what happens. They call all the Black folks and they're like, what do you think of Joe Biden's racial justice executive orders? And I'm like, look, I think that they're a step in the right direction and there is so much more to go. And when we go to those places, we have to apply a racial justice lens to everything. We keep siphoning off certain issues as equity issues, as identity issues, as race issues. Guess what? Environmental issues are racial justice issues, because the fact that I taught a classroom of students, the majority of whom had asthma, even though that was not the case if you went to Northwest DC, that is a racial justice issue just as much as it is an environmental justice issue, right? That has to be part of the Green New Deal too. And I know that it is. When we talk about student debt, we know that the median white borrower has paid 94% of their debts back by after 20 years. Whereas after that same amount of time, the median Black borrower has still 95% of their loans left to pay, right? So student debt cancellation is just as much of a racial justice issue as anything else. These stimulus checks are just as much of a racial justice issue as anything else. So just like across the board, policy requires an equity lens and a racial justice lens, so does education policy.